Okay, welcome back everybody. We're in the second semi-final of the Dynamic Billiard Estonian Open here in Tallinn. Series Mohamed Sofi up against the Terminator, Niels Fayen. We have Mohamed at the table. Having a real enjoyable time of late, Mohamed. Of course, we all know silver medalist at the World Championships, losing out to Francisco. I know there's a lot of people who would love to see a repeat of that final. I'm sure Mohamed is one of those. Revenge is on the list, I guess. Sofi off to a flyer, 1-0 leading Niels Fayen, race to 9. Maurice is just saying as well what I just said, that it will be fun to see Mohamed against Francisco. Yeah, we've had a lot of comments on that as well. Second referee, Vladislav Belkovs from Latvia, not far away, made it here for this tournament along with his counterpart from Lithuania, the previous referee Gintaras. As we watch Mohamed breaking off in rack 2, leading 1-0. Just about illegal, that 9 ball creeping just into the kitchen or passing a break line. For those of you who are not aware of the kitchen, a bit of a cluster there with a 2, 3, and 5. Not sure what Mohamed looked like. He was going to try and play the combination, 1 onto the 7. 7's just sitting nasty place, really not quite in the pocket but close enough. Yeah, makes it, but has he got the reward? I don't think so. Playing a very good safety. Very good indeed. That's a little too close to the 5 ball for jumping. So Neil's going to have to kick. See in the background there from Germany, Tobias Bongers. I think he's talking to Ramazan Dinsa. Not sure about that, but Tobias it was. Neil's kicking, making the 1, but he's left it for Sofi. not easy to get position for that two ball. Certainly cannot pot it, otherwise it'd have been there by now. Very, very fast player, but he's banked it. Intentional, I think so. Has he got a 3-5 combination in his locker? No. Now that's a safety. Got a tough shot here. Not a lot of place on the table to hide either the three or the cue ball. So Nils decides to bank it himself. Great shot. And position for the five. So asking about the next Euro Tour stop. You got the dates right there, Michal. 14th to 17th of April. In lovely St. Johann in Pongau, Austria. Very close to Salzburg. It's one of the most popular tour stops on the calendar. A lot of players like it. The main hotel there, Alpina Sports Wellness Center. It's very, very popular. I think a lot of players try and book the hotel 1 year in advance. The other hotels are not bad either. It's always nice to stay in the same hotel where the event's played, as Niels Fehn ties this match up 1-1. So Mohamed playing a safety and Niels banking. Good bank on the free. Set himself up for the five. Mohamed knows he's in a match. And following Austria, we go back up north to Finland in Tampere. There we have the European Championships for men and women and wheelchairs, and also a Eurotour event for the men and the women. Don't know if any of you saw earlier today Poland's Olivia Zalewska winning her fifth Eurotour title, beating Germany's Veronika Ivanovskaya in the final. Niels Fehn breaking in rack three, all squared 1-1. Well, Niels getting a real good break there. Three balls in off the break. His next ball is the red three. Six ball hanging in the pocket, so Neil's going to have to play a combination, three to the six. I'll try and play this so he keeps position four to three. Oh, he lost it a little bit there. I've still got a shot at it. I think he lost it. And just pointing out that Sophie is having a real good start to this year, of course. Surprising thing with Mohamed is his best result so far on the Euro Tour was third place. I think that was back in 1921 would be difficult. No, 2021, he was third. And last year was sort of a mixed bag of results, really. I think one of his problems is his speed sometimes. At Euro Tour, you have a lot of players. You've got to be careful who you're playing against. Similar could be said about Tony Drago, another fast player. Give him an open opportunity and he can pot from anywhere. Sometimes the speed just messes you up. As Niels Fayen makes light work of these balls and this 9-ball for a 2-1 lead. There you have Niels Fayen in the lead 2-1 over Syria's Mohamed Sofi. Mike's just pointed out, I said 1921, you know, 2021. Give me a break. Yeah, it would be interesting reading some of your chats there. Can Mohamed keep this momentum going? So like I said, it has been a bit of a surprise package, really. Results on the Euro Tour haven't been anything really to write home about. He's always knocking on the door. But like I said, I think his speed sometimes lets him down. There's a lot of good players on the Euro Tour now. Again, a good break, nice spread, but not the nicest shot on the one ball now. I can see Mohamed trying to get a safety hit, put cue ball up on the top rail, use the 6 or the 5. Just get a 2 ball a little bit lower. Not sure. He's got the snooker. It's an easy kick for Niels off the side rail. Problem is, where do you leave it? And kicking, there's no guarantee. He's actually coming down table to kick at this two rails. Cue ball, gotta hang, he's good. Stays on the table. Petri Karapul just asking about the tapping of the tables. Yeah, we have a template that we use prior to the tournament. We just tap a few divots into the cloth, makes the ball sit nice and frozen together. Then there's no arguments, there's no 5 minutes making a rack, all of those sort of things. But of course, bringing in the template creates a different dimension, and that's why the three-point rule was introduced. If players work out these things, they can do a cut break, a soft break, and that's not 9-ball. 9-ball should be fast and furious. That's why the three-point rule is in. Of course, we don't like it ourselves, but when you try and control 24 tables with one or two referees, it's impossible. 7, 8 and 9 left for Niels to open up a 2 rack lead. It's a race to 9 for a place in the final. Francisco Sanchez Ruiz waiting. A 2 minute commercial break after this 9 ball. That is for the TV stations that this is being broadcast live on, so stay with us. 2 minutes and we'll be back. Thanks for being patient. We are back now, rack number 5, Niels van Breken leading 3-1. Mihai just asking about the EPBF referees there. I'll get to that in a sec when we see the result there. Of course, nothing down brings Mohamed to the table. That one goes past the 3, cross table a couple of times. He'll have position for the 2. Oh, he left that a little bit short. So yeah, the referee, if you wanted to join the referees, they do have referee courses. I don't exactly know off my head when the next one is planned, but if you look on the EPBF website, you'll see some contact numbers there. You can always get in touch if you feel like joining the referee group. I think there is approximately 35 qualified referees within that group. And they're used at various tournaments all around Europe and other parts of the world. shots are coming up a little bit short. I mean, it's not affected him just yet. I think he has to work a bit better on the positional plays. Fine, you can play these shots, but percentage-wise, eventually, you're going to come unstuck when you have to keep playing amazing shots every one. I think that's where this man sometimes fails. A little bit like Joshua in his younger day as well. Can pot from anywhere. Doesn't mean that you have to make every shot hard. Over the years, he's learned a little bit. And I'm sure Mohammed will, as he clears that rack after Niels's dry break. Trailing now 2-3. Just asking about the tables. Yes, at each Eurotour event, the tables are for sale. You can buy a table from the Eurotour. If you're lucky and quick, you can choose the final table. But at the end of the day, all tables, the players have played on virtually all of them. You always claim Francisco, the world champion, played on your table. But if you're interested, again, there's some email addresses on the EPBF website. You can contact there. Why not buy yourself a Eurotour table? Number 6, Mohammed Solfi breaking off, trailing 2-3. I'm making a couple of balls off the break there. Got a shot on the one. I think angle there. He might be trying to just get that cue ball to bump into the 6, hold it for the 4, or maybe does he just squeeze it past? Got to be careful centre pocket if he does. Yeah, he uses the 6 as a blocker, keeps position for the 4. Dennis Grabe is in question on the chat there. How did he do? Well, he lost to Niels Fayen in an earlier round. In quarterfinals. Petri Garapu asking about the tap-in. Yeah, of course, when the tables are tapped, the balls are frozen, that's for sure. And generally, during the time of a tournament, it varies. Out of 24 tables, I think 2 have been sort of re-tapped. So other than that, no. I mean, you've got to remember the impact on that one ball from the cue ball is making a sort of a crater at the front of the table. That's why you go in your pool rooms, you have big divots, because the impact, the ball's got nowhere to go, so it forces itself down and then up. As Sophie ties this match up 3-3 now. Race to 9 for a place in tonight's final against Francisco Sanchez Ruiz. My preference, well, personally, I would prefer a triangle, but then you need 24 referees, because You will never get any of these players to make a rack for themselves or each other within 5 minutes. And that you cannot have. As a spectator, you watch them mess around there, it's no good. But that's just the problem at the moment. If you had a referee at every table, I certainly would use triangles. A tapping template is used to save a lot of time and arguments, and at the end of the day, it's fair for both players. They both get the same tight rack. And I've seen a lot of things, oh, a referee's not racking them right, but they can't rack them wrong. Players can hit it wrong. That's for sure. So that's where you'll see the variation in the racks. Wow, three balls in off the break again. Six is hanging in the pocket. Players have found the sweet spot. Yeah, the three-point rule is still in place the whole tournament. In the earlier rounds, of course, there's no referee at the table, but we don't remove it for the final rounds. That, of course, we speak with the players a lot about. Same with a shot clock, you know, speak to them about the shot clock from the beginning. Should there be a minute after the break, all of that. And the top players say, no, keep it the same all the way through. Great shot. There was nowhere for that four until Niels drew back. Niels Fayen now, again, getting his nose in front, leading 4-3. Sinan Maros asking about the rack or template. It's in the form of a sort of a mouse mat, if you like, with some holes. They're not readily available. The last time we produced them was 15 years ago, because we still have them, a few in stock that we use for the events. But because of all the magic racks around everything else, we only use it for the tournaments. We tried the magic rack as well, and variations of them, but there brings its own problems too. There you see that tremendous opening break. There you go, Michal, your question about who makes the racks has been answered there on the chat. Funnily enough, Paul Problems answered you. So that's quite ironic. Nice to see. Illegal there. Only one ball down, and only the seven ventured into the kitchen. Has he got the gap? He has. Well judged. It's not the biggest gap on the table there. But he's found it. Kicked off of that rail there. Niels wanted to be just square with the eight ball, really, for that six. A five just on the rail. Gjul getting a much stronger bounce. Has missed. He's got lucky, I think. And only judging by where we're sitting, but that's seven. Just hindering. Or is it? I think it is. It's going to be close. Referee is keeping a very, very close eye on it. Going for the bank there, but he's also got away with it. Seven ball blocking the path to a six. Neil's going to have to kick. Neil's getting another good return. Judge that shot. So if he's going for a very thin slice at a six and gets it, another very, very good safety shot. Niels kicking and missing. Really hit the wrong place on a cushion there. Match all square again, 4-4. A mistake on the six ball by Niels Fayen allows Mohamed Sofi to clear the remaining balls. Match all square, 4-4. Race to nine. making a blue two off the break. Concede a one, and you can see it there. He's got to play the 1-8 combination if he wants to try and run this rack out. Let's see if he wants to go for it. Vicente on the chat there. Good evening to you, or afternoon. Evening it is in Portugal. Are we going to see you on one of the events this year? As Neil's attempts the combination. Left Mohammed with a tempting bank shot here. And the way this guy plays, I think he's going. Oh, hits a knuckle. I think he's got away with it. Just bounced far enough away from the pocket there. Not sure if there's enough of a gap to squeeze that one into the center. And Neil's attempting an aggressive shot. Didn't work out, leave Sophie. Good chance now to get himself back in the lead. Last time was after the first rack. Stole that off of Neil's break. Since then, Neil's been one or two racks in front of Mohammed. It's starting to motor, but again, his speed can be a hindrance. We're looking here at a possible combination 5-6. Not sure if Mohammed is a bit of a Karen player, thin slice the 5 and pot the 6. What a tremendous shot. That was a lot more difficult than it looked on camera. Really, really good shot. Controlling the cue ball better now. And this 9 ball will give Mohammed Sophie a 5-4 lead, and we're going to go for a 4-minute commercial break. Players have a timeout now, so stay tuned. We'll be back with you in 4 minutes' time. Thank you. Wow. Blink and you miss it. Nine ball break. Wow. Well, after mandatory timeout, Mohamed Soufik breaks off and makes the nine. Made a three ball off the break. Hasn't got a clear shot on the one. Some technical issue. Back again. Yeah, hasn't got a shot on the one there. Just lost the signal, but we're good again. That was a real good shot there from Niels. Playing rail first, potting the one, getting position for the two. Four ball is down by the nine ball. Cue ball very close to the rail, so it's going to be a tough one. That was really good as well. Two tremendous shots in a row from Niels Fayen. Reading through some of your chat about the robotics in players and everything. I think they're, to a certain degree, I agree with a lot of what you say. The game itself brings it in too. As Niels reduces the deficit, trailing 5-6. Talk about robotics in pool. speaking to quite a few of the top players, and we all talk about the tight pockets. That will only increase the sort of robotic dynamics of the game, because players won't take a chance. When the pockets are a little bit forgiving, you're going to see some real risk-taking and great shot-making. When you put the pockets like a snooker table, it changes a lot of things. And according to the players, this is not me, according to the players, it does change their way of playing. But I mean, in personality, that's something else. I'd like to see a little bit more flair and individual personality. I don't mean being complete, you know what, but at least enjoying yourself out there. Four balls now off of Sophie's break. A great shot on the two. Get back up there for the pink four. Sophie now with a 7-5 lead. Making the two ball off the break there. Can see the one. And take it to the left corner. He's looking at it now. Player put a bit of draw on the cue ball. Try and keep position. Just past the seven ball for the three. wrenching it round three rails. This nine will reduce the deficit, trading 6 games to 7. There he does. Getting closer to a hill-hill thriller, and we're going to have another commercial break for 2 minutes, so stay tuned and we'll be back very shortly. Just about making the 3-point rule there. 6 ball already down. The 4 and the 8 made it to the kitchen line. Looking at taking it to the center pocket. They can get back down for the 2. It's a rarity. Mohammed using his time extension. Oh, just got a little kiss off the 3. Sends him behind the 2. Good shot there from Mohammed Sofi, tying the 2 ball up as well with the 8. look at the knight. Oh, I thought he was going to get a little lucky there, but he's got lucky anyway. Cue ball behind a three. Mohammed now with a jump stick. Going airborne. Oh, wow. What a great shot. Jumps the three, makes the two. Position on the three. This is a race to nine. Sophie really shooting well. 7, 8, and 9 to get on the hill. And we could have a repeat of the World Nine Ball Championships final. Francisco Sanchez waiting in the wings. Mohammed, Sophie taking care of his business here, leading now 8-6. On the hill. So we just see Sophie's jump there. Fayen to break in rack 15, trailing 6-8. Just break in to stay in the match. That's a illegal break there from Niels Fayen. Only one ball in the pocket, one ball in the kitchen. Snookered behind the six, so only Niels can play a push out after an illegal break. And when you play Mohammed, Sophie, where do you leave it? Sophie didn't get the snooker he was looking for. Niels can see all of the one. Getting a good safety. We're going to have to kick off the top rail. Left that one, kicked at it. On ball available to the centre. Six and seven a little tied up, but nothing that Niels could not handle. Just looking at the six ball. Does he go to the centre pocket on the right hand side as we look? Niels's position will tell us that. Always missed the four. Missed the four, trying to get position for the six. Can Mohamed Sofi capitalise on Niels's mistake? Close out this match. On Mohamed, making a rare mistake on leaving it tentatively close to that pocket for Niels Fahed. Niels Fahed gets closer, now trailing 7-8. Niels will be breaking next. SMK is asking about the prize money at these events. There's a guaranteed €45,000 each event, six events. We guarantee €270,000 each year. back 16. Mohamed Sofi breaking off to close out this match. Book his place in the finals against Francisco Sanchez Ruiz. And of all the times, it's a dry break. Just when you thought you could close the door, throw away the key, someone pushes it open. Niels Fayen with a reprieve. Not sure if the three ball actually goes past the five to the corner, which is the angle Niels will have if he cuts this two. Banking, but where's the cue ball? Just always going to be a risk there. The cue ball bumping into the four, staying close to the rail. This is a real tough shot on the three because he's got to get back up there for that four. Getting a bump on the wrong side of that six. There's a teaser for Mohamed. Mistake there from Mohamed. Big mistake. Just looking there. As the finals continue, straight after this semi-final, of course. Live broadcast continues. Players just come in, change over. Francisco has a practice. And we get the final underway. next 9 ball to give us a heel-heel match. Oh, wow, that was close. I think Neil's heart skipped a beat there. But this is a heel-heel match. A one-rack shootout for a place in tonight's final. Fan having won the lag as a luxury of breaking off the last rack of this semi-final. That's a really good break. Nicely spread. Niels has a chance to ruin everyone's wishes for a Sophie Sanchez final. It's not over, but Niels is at the table. Just stopping there. And people moving around in the audience. Niels, having won his last Eurotour event last year in Austria. Looking at another one to his illustrious career. One of the most successful pool players on the Eurotour. Drama. Big mistake there. Positional error to get onto that four. Sophie. What a great opportunity here. Sophie makes it into the final. He'll be playing against Francisco Sanchez Ruiz in a few moments. There's not much of a break in between, so we'll be back with you in a few moments' time. Hope you enjoyed that and see you all again soon. Bye-bye for now.